Hummingbird Resources has announced that first concrete's been poured on time and on budget at its Yanfolila gold mine project in Mali. It'll provide the base for the plant, with pours continuing over the next 3 months. Several other long lead equipment orders have also been placed. Well, Managing Director Dan Betts is here with me now. Good to speak to you.
Thanks for having me.
In fact, the last time we spoke, talking about 2015, how busy it was, how's 2016 shaped up for you?
Busier. I mean, different sort of busy though. 2015 was challenging. You know, I guess the market was even more difficult then than it's been this year. And we were doing a lot of studies and a lot of feasibility studies and trying to do the due diligence to finalise an arrangement with the finances we had back then. 2016 has been much more positive, really. At the start of the year, we did a significant equity raise. So we sort of recapitalised Hummingbird and we had a lot of equity. And with that, we could commit to building Yanfolila. And then since then, it's just been an awful lot of work building the team and finishing the detailed engineering and mobilising on site. So it's been a different sort of busy, but a much more enjoyable busy, really. I mean, it's been on the front foot, being proactive and doing what it's all about, which is getting this mine built.
Look, first concrete poured on time and on budget. What's the next step?
Well, we are only at the start of the build process. So, I mean, if we were off budget and off time now, it'd be a problem. But no, I mean, to be honest, everything is going as well as I could have hoped. I mean, the main thing really for me since the equity raise early in the year is the construction team we've brought on board is absolutely first class. And I mean, all the engineering that's been done in South Africa with our EPCM contractor, which is Senet, and our own team has gone extremely well and to plan, and obviously the mobilization to site, first concrete pour last week. Everything's, you know, touch wood, everything's going as well as I could hope. So that's great.
In terms of the budget, you're confident it's enough to get the job done?
Well, I am. I mean, I'm obviously mindful that there's been a history of projects being built in Africa going over time and over budget and wrong. So, I mean, everyone at Hummingbird is painfully aware of the financial discipline we need to approach this project with. But I'm confident that we're on top of it, and I'm confident it's going as well as we could hope. So, yeah, I think so.
Well, the bit that we're all looking forward to, pouring first gold, are we on track? What's the time frame for that?
We nearly slipped in the press release, said, you know, first gold poured at concrete, but we didn't get away with that. The timetable is, I think, I'm always told never put a date to it, but the date in the schedule is the 19th of December next year. So, you know, as you put your project timeline together, there's obviously thousands of items that come together and your critical path, and that magic date is the 19th of December. So, you know, everything's towards beating that.
Well, speaking of that magical path, what other milestones are there, and what can investors look forward to hearing about between now and then?
Well, there are hundreds and hundreds of different milestones, and none of them are particularly significant unless they go wrong. But obviously the big landmark milestones, I mean, pouring first concrete is always one, because you have to be mobilised to do that, which we've done. Another one is the land acquisition from all the local partners and farmers in the area where we're working. I mean, I think we've bought land from 65 different farmers in Mali. So when we started on this programme, there was a lot of cynicism that that would be done smoothly, but we've already completed that task. It's gone very smoothly, and the local communities fully engaged in support of the project. So that's actually a very big milestone, but one that doesn't make much noise. From here going forward, obviously the mill being delivered to site, the CIL tanks and the plant being built, and then the mobilisation of the contract miner middle of next year to start the pre-strip and early mining works is a big milestone. But really, it's just constant news flow from here on in.
Constant news flow, something that's out of your control, but price of gold steadily recovering.
Well, I mean, it had a scare a couple of weeks ago, didn't it? It dropped sort of $100 in a week, and I think everyone looked at it and thought, oh, maybe it's not still going up, but it seems to be recovering. But look, we're in a totally different place to where we were a year ago. I mean, a year ago, every analyst said gold's going below 1,000, and it was a dismal place to be. And then it's gone up 25% this year. And it seems like the sentiment on the street is they believe it's going up further. I mean, for me, that's not really, you know, that my job is to deliver the project on time, on budget, and make sure when we're producing, our operating costs are what we've said they'll be. So if the gold price stayed where it was at 1250 gold, then our economics are fantastic. So I'll be happy. And really, because we've raised so much equity, we're going to be extremely indebted. You know, as a gold mining company, most projects that are built a 70% built with debt and 30% with equity, you know, this project will be the other way around. So all of those cash flows will come back to shareholders. And once this project is built and it's real in people's mind, all of a sudden, I think people look at Yanfolila and Hummingbird and they'll go, hang about, you've got a company here that's producing 130,000 ounces a year. It's hardly got any debt and it's in the lowest quartile of cash cost producers. You know, this is, it's a fantastic business. And, you know, that's what all our effort is on since that fundraise and for the next 12 months.
Look, let's touch on your project in Liberia. Bring us up to speed there.
So in Liberia, obviously, I mean, the project in Liberia is basically on slow burn. I mean, it's a much bigger project. And the original strategic decision to move to Mali was because it was smaller and we could get our heads around the funding requirement. In Liberia, you've got a much bigger project with a much longer mine life and ultimately a bigger financing need. So the way the market was, that was going to be a challenge. I think by moving to Mali, though, the market saw that as Hummingbird abandoning its project in Liberia, which is absolutely not the case. I mean, there's the project in Liberia is a fantastic long-term project. It has a lower IRR. It has a higher all-in sustaining cash cost than Yanfolila, so it has a smaller margin, but it's much bigger. I mean, it will go on for decades, and it's obviously a bigger challenge to get it into production. So what we're doing in the background while we're focused on Mali is looking at ways to reconfigure the plant, optimize how we can get early cash flows from the project, looking at ways we can reduce the power cost. We've just conducted a hydroelectric feasibility study with the IFC, part of the World Bank in Liberia. So there's lots of low-level stuff going on in the background, but really you can't, you know, it's a lot of work building a gold mine. You can't do two at once. So what we're really doing is optimizing and reconfiguring that Liberian project so that as Hummingbird develops, we have that huge optionality in the background.
Look, two great projects on the go, a significant milestone for Yanfolila. I wish you all the best.
Thanks very much.
Thanks, Dan, for coming in.
Thank you.